4-year-old Gloria Kobusingye runs about playfully. Amid her play, she stops to sing and dance. When asked her name, she responds quickly and even mentions her age. These are cardinal signs that Kobusingye is responding and recovering well from an epilepsy surgery she received in October 2023 at Kiwa Hospital in Imbale City. One of Kobusingye's caregivers, Ventrina Mbabazi, shares her treatment and recovery story.
On 30th November 2022, we received Gloria Kobusingye, and she came in with different problems. But like a week, 1 or 2 weeks, we started noticing some abnormal behaviors, whereby she had visual hallucinations. She could be there and start shouting. Later, like 2 days, she started falling down. So we had to confirm that really this child is convulsing. We had to see that those are where they were seizures. So we ran to Mengo Hospital, we did a CT scan, and the CT scan confirmed that she had a problem on the brain.
After medics at Mengo hinted on the possibility of Kobusingye having a problem with her brain, she was later taken to St. Francis Hospital in Zambia, where confirmatory tests were done. Results indicated that she had epilepsy and surgeons recommended surgery. Later, arrangements were made and Kobusingye had to undergo a successful 12-hour surgery at Kiwa Hospital in Imbale City. Kobusingye is the reason the Minister of Health recently launched epilepsy surgery in Uganda as part of the national celebration to mark the International Epilepsy Day under the theme Milestones on My Epilepsy Journey. Kobusingye's case is not in isolation since the inception of the epilepsy surgical program in 2021. About 8 children have received surgery, as experts explain.
So we started planning the surgery in July. It's when he told us. We started planning the surgery until October, when the surgery was done. We took Gloria to Mbare Kiwa Hospital. The surgery was done. May I call a super major surgery that took for about 12 hours.
However, not all children with epilepsy require the surgery. Some children grapple with drug-resistant epilepsy and continuously get seizures which lead to brain damage, consequently affecting their quality of life.
Many children suffer from things like stroke. You find the side of the brain that is stroked out having seizures, and this spread to the good side of the brain. So we offer a procedure called hemispherectomy, where we disconnect the right and left sides of the brain. In that way, the seizures cannot move to the good side of the brain, therefore curing them of their epilepsy. Other causes of epilepsy could be brain tumors, and these ones, when they are removed, the seizures can be controlled.
The signs and symptoms of epilepsy vary based on the type, as Dr. Angelina Kakoza explains.
Now, the signs and symptoms of epilepsy vary depending on the type of epilepsy, because we have those that are focal, that is involving one side of the body, and then there are those that are generalized, that is involving the whole body. So usually you find that the person can just, if they are generalized, suddenly loses consciousness, falls down, and starts having uncontrolled movements of both the hands and the legs. If it is focal, that is involving one side, the person may be aware or may not be aware, but you find one part of the body is the one that is moving. It can be shaking in an uncontrollable way. And that is how such a person is known to have epilepsy, which may be focal or generalized.
Okay. And these seizures, may it not be the convulsive one, may it have somebody just looking in one side like this, or may it have somebody having other signs like vomiting. What I want to mention is that epilepsy will depend in the part of the brain where the problem is. That is very important. If it is the area of the brain that is responsible for vision, somebody may present with the visual problems. if it is area responsible for movement, somebody might wander around when he's actually having seizures. However, people might wait for the jerking, which doesn't occur. So, but the commonest way epilepsy presents are the frequent jerking. Others could be absent, those are the signs and symptoms. Others might have abnormal, just falls down. Those are the different manifestations of what? Of epilepsy.
The causes of epilepsy are numerous, ranging from genetics, infections, while some are unknown. Confirmation of epilepsy is based on the disease history of the patient.
It could be genetic. What do I mean by genetic? Genetic means that you inhale this gene that is potentially a cause of epilepsy. However, that is one in six. People think that is the commonest cause, but it's only one in what? In six. Could be genetic. The other cause could be infection. And in our setting, infection is the commonest cause. Birth injuries, infections can all lead to epilepsy.
There are do's and don'ts when it comes to managing a person with an epileptic seizure attack. In Uganda, a recent national study conducted in 40 districts by Duke University and School of Public Health, Makerere University, College of Health Sciences, found a prevalence of 1.69%, that is, over 770,000 Ugandans living with epilepsy.
Now, when a person has a seizure, it's always important that you should not run away. Please don't run away from such a person. In fact, be of help to them, because epilepsy is not contagious. Do not put anything in the mouth, be it a spoon, be it a stick, because you think that probably they're going to swallow their tongue or bite their teeth or bite their mouth. Please just ensure that if the person has any tight clothing, loosen it. If it's a tie, loosen the tie. Make the person lie on their left lateral side, and usually within less than 5 minutes, that seizure should stop. And you should time how long that seizure has happened, but do not in any way interfere by putting anything in the mouth to try to stop them by holding on to them and saying, stop, stop. Remember, this is something that is out of their control.
Story compiled by Agnes Chota Lingerire for the news.